everybody. This is Christopher with AG Productions. Welcome to another edition of Watch Me Work on Sorsha. Now, first and foremost, you may notice that the camera angle has changed slightly. Then again, you might not. I have no idea. No clue how perceptive you are. But if you did notice, what I've done or attempted to do is get you guys a better shot of kind of what I'm seeing. So what I did was I extended the length of the legs of my tripod, lifted it up much, much further to give you a sort of slightly more over-the-shoulder look instead of a little bit from the side. Don't know if it's going to work. And, I mean, as far as visuals, I know we're fine. But what's kind of bothering me, and I guess I'll figure it out in the editing process, and this may end up, like I said, only being one video like this, is if I'm talking, I'm normally talking towards the miniature, which means that the microphone has to pick up basically the sound in this area right here. It's not picking up the sound unless I turn towards the camera directly into the mic. So it's sort of picking up this bounce back sound. That being said, I don't know if the increased distance away from the camera will affect the sound quality at all, but we'll see what happens. As I said, this may end up being just a one shot like this, but we'll see. So anyway, let's get to Sorsha here. Sorsha is a unique miniature in that it presents some very odd painting challenges because of the way it's laid out. You can see the model is very, very open in that you have a lot of you have a lot of layers of things, but they're all sort of flayed out. It's not like the cloak is covering everything. It's spread open, which means you have to come in, you have to paint the insides of the cloak and all that kind of stuff. But because you've got these layers of the miniature, I mean, if I were to take the miniature and lay it on its side, you've got obviously the back here, then you've got this cloak, then you've got this cloak, then you've got the main body. And then you've got, for instance, things like the face and the weapon that stick out further, and even the weapon back here that sticks out backwards. So it's a very three-dimensional model, even though it is a very flat miniature. And that can present some problems because, essentially, when painting a miniature like this, I have to go back and forth a lot. It's not like I can really go to one area, finish that one area, and then move to the next. It's sort of go to one area, and excuse me, yawning very late in the evening. It's sort of like go to one area, kind of start that one area, and then go to another area, and start that area, then go back to the first area and finish that area. And it's this kind of bouncing around process. So this may end up being a little bit different as far as layout of how things flow for this Watch Me Work series. I will do my absolute best, though, to kind of keep things consistent, keep things moving, and if I do need to jump around, I will let you know why I'm doing it. So, good golly, I apologize. Man, I gotta stop doing these late-night videos. But that's kind of what I want to talk about today, because initially I had intended to paint the face of the miniature. Let me zoom in here so you can kind of see what I'm looking at. If we can get in that far, which I'm sure we can, because this camera is awesome. All right. So, let's see here. There we go. Okay, so if we do the face of the miniature, got no real problem accessing the face. The problem comes in the inside. Let's see. Let's get in frame. There we go. That's the one problem being up close. I can't really move a whole lot. So, the problem comes in... the inside of this left-hand shirt collar, or armor collar, or whatever you want to call it. Because in order to paint inside that area, I don't have a brush thin enough to fit between the cheek and this collar. And so what I'm going to have to do is sort of fake it. And the way I'm going to fake it is by just introducing a really dark color back there, probably going to be gray or a real dark gray. And then later on, coming in and painting the face, painting the skin tone sort of forward of where it actually starts. In other words, I'm not going to go all the way back on this cheek back here. I'm not going to go all the way back to the hair, but what I'll do is I'll leave that gray back there, and it'll kind of appear like a shadow on the miniature. Same thing for this area right here. Right in the neck area, you know, I've really got to work into this area before I can even do the collars themselves. Because if I try and do the collars and then try and be really neat and tidy inside this area right there on the neck, it's just not going to happen. So what I've got to do is I've got to paint this area first. And when that area is finished, then I have to come in and lay down just a little bit of a base color on this collar over here. Don't have to worry about the collar over here, but I'll go ahead and do it since I'll have that base color mixed up. Once that base color dries a little bit, then we'll come in, we'll paint the face up a little bit, and then we'll come back over here, highlight this very open spot in the collar that you can see right there, because that's, I mean, you know, it may get a little bit of light, so we'll highlight that, and then we'll come to the top of the collar and highlight that, but very back and forth. I apologize for all the yawning, guys, but not a straightforward miniature like I normally would paint, at least on camera. So, the way we're going to start this off is just go ahead and come in and paint that neck piece. But since I've already got some gray on my palette here, I'm going to go ahead and paint several other areas as well that are eventually going to be a dark grayish black kind of a color. All right, so I'm just going to come in very simply, not going to be all neat and tidy because I don't need to be. And I'm just going to sort of poke this color in to this area right here. Now, ideally, according to the photographs from Privateer Press and a lot of the photographs I've seen on Cool Mini or Not, a lot of people do that central neck area in red. To me, I don't like it, and I'll tell you why. You know, we're gonna get through the next video without yawning. I don't know how we're gonna do it, but we're gonna do it. So if we do it in red, basically what we have is red in the center, and then these outside pieces of this collar are going to be red, probably maybe even the inside. Hadn't really decided on that one yet. And then you're going to have this whole upper chest piece right here that's going to be red. And then if I remember correctly, I think I'm going to end up painting this red. Hadn't really decided yet. And so you're really going to have a lot of red focused in this area of the miniature. Not to mention that the arms themselves are going to be red. And it would really help if I got in frame so you guys could see what I'm talking about. Okay, so this little collar area, I just painted black, or just painted gray. A lot of people paint that red. But this area is going to be red. This area is going to be red. This area is going to be red. The arms are going to be red. And then you're going to have red kind of showing on the edge of this cloak over here, and maybe a little bit on the edge over here. The shoulder pads probably going to end up being red, so you might be able to see a little bit of them. So there's going to be a lot of red right up in here. And so what I want to do is kind of break that up. And the best way to break that up is with another color that we're already going to be using on the miniature, which is going to be a dark gray color. And I'm going to go ahead and apply that in a couple of other areas as well, such as the inside of the cloak. All right, so we're going to go ahead and just come in here just like this and apply a dark gray color. And all this is going to do is just give us a nice neutral tone for the inside of the cloak. If we were to paint this in a bright red color, like we're going to paint the outside of the cloak, it's going to really, really detract from the miniature because it's going to be just screaming red. The whole thing's just going to be screaming at you, and you don't want that. You want some variation between, you know, your primary colors and your neutral colors. You want some variation in light colors and dark colors. Now, for the majority of this miniature, I'm going to be painting a little bit differently than a lot of the press photos. I'm going to be doing a much darker version of Sorcha here. My red is going to be much more, maybe a crimson color. A lot of the press photos for this show a very orange kind of red. And while there's nothing wrong with that, That's not what we're going to be doing here today. Don't want that kind of a look for this model. I want a really deep, deep red color. And one of the reasons is we've got this slate base that we're going to be working with. And if we do a really deep red on the rest of the miniature, it kind of gives it a very, very, very warm feeling. And when we come in with the lighter blue highlights on the slate, that'll give us a nice cool feeling, which will contrast nicely and make the miniature really kind of pop, so to speak. So, I'm just going to grab a little bit more of this paint and come in here to the side of this cloak piece right here. And again, I'm not really overly concerned about getting this stuff in the perfect exact areas, because I know that I'm going to have to come back and paint a lot of it again. But what this will do is it will help any areas that are going to be in shadow. The areas that are going to be in shadow, it'll kind of give me an idea of what those areas are and what they're going to look like, roughly speaking, when we're done, which will help me to sort of choose the right colors for the right locations for the rest of the mini. All right, there we go. Now, the leggings are going to be a grayish color as well, but I'm not 100% sure about the boots yet. I've seen several different versions of this. Some of them go with a black, some of them go with a red, some of them go with a brown. Haven't really decided myself yet. I really think that we ought to do some red, and the reason being, obviously, again, if all we do in red is the top of the miniature, it's going to look really, really, really strange. We need to introduce some red into the bottom of the model. And I don't mean just on the outside here on the cloak, because as you look at it, the cloak is kind of an extraneous detail. It doesn't really look like it actually belongs to the miniature. So what we need to do is we need to pick something in the main body of the miniature itself to color in red. And that may end up being this little tabard piece right here. It might be end up being the boots themselves. It might end up being both of them. I haven't really decided yet, like I said. But we need something on the lower portion of the body to kind of match up with the amount of red that we have on the upper portion of the body. So, that has, apparently, from what I can tell anyway, looks like it's dried. So, we'll come in now and let's do a minuscule sort of highlight, because this is going to be, I mean, really in shadow area. And don't want a lot of color on this at all. So, I'm really going to go back and visit the colors that I utilized for doing the hat. Just kind of to keep things consistent. It's one of the keys I learned long, long, long time ago from the Painting Wizards Workshop VHS tapes, was utilizing the exact same colors on several portions across the miniature to kind of keep things cohesive and consistent. So in other words, we're using the same gray that we previously used. Now I could obviously use a different gray. It's not going to hurt anything, but it might not appear as uniform if I utilize a different gray than if I use something I've already used, okay? So, there's that, and I'm going to put one more small highlight on there, and I do mean small. All right, there we go. Let's just get a little dab on my brush here, and odds are pretty good, as I said previously. I'll come back in long, long, long time in the future somewhere, and place just a tiny, tiny hint of a glaze in this area. Just kind of tone it back down and bring the black out a little bit more. Now that's a little bit strong in the highlight area, so I'm going to go back to my original color, pick up just a bit of that, and see what we can do about fixing this. Now I gotta get the hair off my brush. There we go. Little piece of dust. Happens from time to time. Okay, there's that. And all I want to do is just sort of clean this area up. Okay, there we go. Not really a huge deal there, but it does kind of help me out to be able to paint the face a lot more easily. So, let's see here. What do we want to do next? Let's move to... well, let's see. Okay, if... trying to think here. If the outside of this piece is going to be red, that means the inside is going to need to match the cape out here. So this whole inside piece needs to be gray also. So let's go ahead and paint that up. Alright. So, make sure I'm still in frame. You know, I hadn't even thought about it. My head might be in the way of the camera. Hopefully not. If it is, I apologize. Alright. Here we go. I suppose I could do this in red. But A, it wouldn't match up with the rest of the cloak, which is not good. But on top of that, I think it's going to be nice because it'll add another little bit of a breakup area. And that'll help us out a lot. So, again, just kind of going around this area that's sort of folded back on itself. So even though I'm painting the outside right now, I'm actually painting the inside of the cloak. Even though it's on the outside. It's sort of inside out. Okay. There we go. I am thinking, just for my own personal sanity and preferences, that this will probably be the only time we use this visual setup. Reason being is it's very difficult for me to see what I'm doing and whether or not I'm on camera or in frame, as you can see there. Not in frame for some of that. It's a lot easier for me to see whether or not I'm in frame when the camera is more to my side as opposed to above me. It's a lot easier to kind of just glance to the side than it is to sort of bend to the side and look up at the same time. I know that sounds sort of sad.
But you can't look up, Christopher?
Well, yeah, I can. It's just something I'm not used to. And I'm not 100% sure that this angle is making much of a difference as far as what you guys can see. So, let's see how it ends up in the editing process. And we'll go from there. But for right now, especially due to the fact that I keep ending up out of frame, and I can't tell when I'm out of frame. That's really bugging me. I don't want to do that to you guys. So, I think we'll end there. About 15, 20 minutes in or so. And we didn't get a whole lot accomplished, truthfully. But we kind of took some steps towards getting the model fleshed out as far as blocking off some of the areas. Next time, no problem, we'll come in and do the face of the miniature. That'll be a fun episode to work on that. And hopefully it will be enjoyable for you as well. And I guarantee I'm not in frame, am I? Let's see. Oh no, crap, I actually am for once. Look at that. That's crazy, right? But yeah, I think this camera angle is not going to cut it. But hopefully, you've kind of enjoyed the video. Maybe you learned something towards the beginning of the video. I don't know. Hopefully you did. But if you have any comments or questions, drop them down in the comment section down below. Feel free to leave a thumbs up on the video, and also subscribe to AG Productions if you haven't done that yet. And that's all I got for you guys today. We'll come in next time with the old camera angle back, and hopefully make a little bit more progress, and hopefully I won't be quite as yawny as I was this time. I think I'm going to go for a nice 11 p.m. run. That usually tends to wake me up and help me out some. But anyway, that's all I got for you guys for right now. So I do appreciate you watching. Thank you very, very much. God bless you all. Have a fantastic day, and I will see you all in the next video.